Hey everybody, it's Rich at RMAutodiag, and today we're going to have a look at a Ford Focus. It's not very happy, and as you can see, we've got all the lights on. Okay, I've got the car plugged in. I've done a code scan on it, and we've got a good few codes in here. So what we're going to do is we're going to have a look through it. What the symptoms are is it has started. It's got all the lights on that you saw a minute ago, which is all those. So engine management, there's an oil light, ABS, traction control, battery light, engine malfunction in the middle there. And there's no rev counter working either. So, and also there is no throttle response. If you press the accelerate pedal, nothing is happening. So, codes from the code scan. So we've got loss of communication with instrument panel. We've got a brake switch fault, clutch switch fault, a mobilizer, and the ABS, we've got another communication fault. Power steering, you've got another communication fault. Another communication fault in the tyre pressure, another communication fault in the airbag. So I think we're gonna go down the route that this may have a CAN bus issue, whether it's an actual module or it's a wiring issue. So what I'll do is I'll get set up and we'll see what the CAN bus is doing, and we'll go from there. All right, just a quick one here. I thought I'd have a quick look at the live data, seeing as we had some clutch and brake pedal codes and stuff, and the accelerator's not working. So I couldn't find a clutch switch one in the engine. We got the brakes, and when I press the brake pedal, we don't seem to see anything. Our accelerator pedal is stuck at 99.9, but also it reads as 0 volts. The rev counter doesn't work, but we do have an RPM signal here. We've got battery voltage, which is showing at 14 volts, so it's charging. We do have MAF reading. We do have a MAP reading with the voltage there. And we do have, it's showing about 1 bar there. And we have fuel rail pressure. So it does seem odd that we have 0 voltage on some of these sensors and that brake one is not working, but we do have some of the other things coming up. So maybe that's something to go off. We'll keep on checking, but yeah, I'll get back to the CAN bus and we'll go from there. Right, okay, so we've just gone into the DLC under the dash here. As you can see, I have got two probes put into pins 16 and 14, which is going to be the CAN bus wires, and I've got an earth hooked up as well. And come up to the scope. Bit of a better shot there. We have got a reasonable signal. It looks quite clean. We've got it mirroring itself, so at the moment that doesn't seem too bad to me. All the lights are still on the dash. I wonder if we restart it whether we'll regain everything, so we'll just quickly try that. Now we've still got a fault there, but that signal doesn't seem too bad. Right, what we'll do is we'll clear these fault codes out and we'll see if it changes that, and we'll go from there. Right, okay, we got a bit of progress. Basically I had a cranking no crank no start when I switched the car back off just there, and we had all the same lights on the dash. What I did was I quickly had a look in the passenger footwell to see if there was any water in the fuse box there, which is also the body control. Didn't see any problems down there. We still didn't have a starting issue. So the only other code that we had to go off was it also complained about the instrument panel, which is a bit of a known issue with these. So I had a non-start. What I did, I wish I caught it on the camera, is I gave the dash a bit of a tap on the top and it cranked and fired straight up. We've got our gauges back, we can rev it up as well. So what I'm going to do is I'll see if I can pull the dash out and see if we can recreate this, and maybe see if we can get into the camber signal and see if we can see any faults there. But I think this is going to be an instrument cluster issue, and it's going to need some solder joints probably doing in the back of it. Right, okay, so we've got scope set up again, and as you can see, we've got some CAN signals, and what we've got is we've got a couple of Panoma probes, and if you can see here, you can see that front one, and it's just pierced into the top of one of the CAN wires at the back of the cluster here, and annoyingly, I can't get it to do it, but for all the wriggling in the world, I can't make this signal drop out. And I kind of wish that I had got a decent video of when this fault occurred, when I was tapping the dash and it restarted, which is quite annoying. But let's say I'm wriggling about here and I just can't quite get it to do it. But what I'm going to do is I've got to take this dash out and I'm going to strip it down, and I think we're going to find that some of the pins where they push through, the solder's no good on them, and it causes bad contacts, and that's why you get the non-starts, and you get various communication errors. It is fairly well known on these. So what I'll do is I'll finish up this video, and what we'll get is I'll probably strip this dash down. Sadly, I mean, this customer has had enough of this car. This is going to scrap, so you know, this is just a test vehicle. I think they do have some other issues with injectors and stuff. Maybe I can get another video out of it for that. Check some diesel injectors. So thanks for watching, and hopefully you can join in for the next one when we strip the dash down. Cheers!